The question is, can we find a general expression that we can use to enable us to solve any problem that involves work done by a variable force? Well, the answer is yes, and that is what we will learn in this lesson. So let us consider this graph that has displacement x of an object on the x-axis and the force on the object for corresponding x values along the y-axis. It is also given that this force changes as x changes, which of course we can see in this graph. That is, this force could be 2x square or 5x or x plus 3 and so on. So mathematically put, it means that force F is a function of x, and we will write it as Fx. So you see, this equation is a way of representing a general variable force. Now we are asked to find the work done by this variable force. And again, we cannot use this equation, that is, work is equal to the product of force and displacement, simply because this equation can be used only when the force is constant and not variable. So what we will do is that for each displacement delta x that is very, very small, we will assume that the force did not change over that very tiny distance. On this graph, it is like saying that here is delta x and we assume force to be constant over this distance. And say it is some average value f, even though the force did actually change from here to here by a very, very small value. Then we can apply the same logic for every delta x displacement and say that at each point, the force can be considered constant for that displacement delta x. So let us say the force here is F1, here F2, here F3, and so on till the end where it is, say, Fn. Then we can say that the work done here is F1 into delta x, here F2 into delta x, here F3 into delta x, all the way up to the last segment where the work done is Fn into delta x. Looking at this expression, you can observe that for each delta x segment, the work done is nothing but the area of the rectangle under the graph made by that delta x segment and force F. So as an example, the height of the segment here is F8 and the width is delta x. So you could say that for this delta x segment, the work done is height F8 into delta x, or the area of this rectangle, that is roughly under the curve. So you could apply the same logic for every delta x and say the work done is equal to the area of the rectangle made by that delta x and the average force at that point. Now, if we sum up the area of all these rectangles, we can find the total work done between xi and xf. However, we should recall that the force we have taken in each segment is an average between the start of the segment and the end of the segment delta x. And therefore, to make the approximation better, we will need to reduce the thickness of the strip delta x and use more strips. And we reduce the thickness of the strip so much that it almost approaches zero. In that case, the number of strips become infinitely large, and we get an exact result that we write as work done is equal to limit of delta x approaching zero, sigma f delta x. And this expression is nothing but the integral of function x dx as the limit changes from x initial to x final. So if you're really liking the way I teach, please subscribe and give thumbs up to this lesson. That'll be helpful. And let's get back to the lesson. So the work done by a variable force can be found using this expression. All we need to know is what the function x is. That is, it is x square or 3x or 4x cube plus 1 and so on. If this is given, we just need to put that expression in place of fx and do the integration by applying the limits. As an example, if you're told that the force changes as a function of x and it is given as f is equal to 3x squared, and then you are asked to find the work done between x equal to 1 meter and x equal to 3 meters, you can calculate the work done as w is equal to integral of 3x squared dx as the limit of x changes from 1 to 3. So integrating, we get w is equal to x cubed as the limit changes from 1 to 3, or w is equal to 3 cubed minus 1 cube, or 26 joules. So the important thing to remember is that if you are given a force versus a displacement graph and you're asked to find the work done between two positions, x1 and x2, then the area bound between x1 and x2 and the curve is equal to the work done by the variable force in that interval. So you see, the topic of work energy is very conceptual in nature, and if you really want to get a strong grip on this topic, I would recommend you head over to this playlist, which covers this topic really well. And like always, if you like this lesson, do give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next lesson.